For me, it's like driving a car. You do an air and you get so much speed into the wall, and you can really feel your edge, and you can carve, and that's for sure a good feeling, and you get higher, and it's it's something that pushes you for sure.
I think the halfpipe riding is the hardest one. It feels pretty good when you go big and you can like have a good run and like do some nice tricks.
I think what I like the most about the pipe riding is just to have like about 5-6 jumps in the row, and there's a lot of rhythm, and it's pretty fast, and I don't know, it's pretty intense, and I like it.
Yeah, I guess I like riding pipe a lot because there's more than one jump in a row, and like think you have to use your edges, and you actually have to know how to ride like really good.
What I heard the other day, that I think it was Xaver Hoffmann saying it, that there's nothing else that brings you faster from like zero, you know, when you're at the dead point, from zero to like, I don't know, you maybe go 50 k's an hour, hit to hit, that's what makes it for me.
I think like Olympics are, they are really big now, yeah, all the sponsors, and it's a really like big event, so it's good for the riders, and it's like every 4 years, so it's pretty hard to get in.
For once, I think it's cool, you can be like a contest guy, and I've never been that competitive, like getting into snowboarding and only ride contests, so I want to have this feeling for this season now, and then just move on.
I think that riders have changed their mind about Olympics, and it's not really like it was at the first or second one, and now it's more like a respectful contest, and I feel good about that because they're gonna be a crazy level, and it's I don't know, just nice to see that, and if it's Olympics will make those people riding that well, I think it's cool.
I think definitely it has changed just because people are younger, and then some people just don't know the roots of snowboarding that much. They just want to ride and do contests and stuff, which is totally fine. That's what I think, but I'm sure there's some people who don't think snowboarding is cool at the Olympics, and they're the core dudes. Sure, there is some bad stuff, like not as much creativity in it, and then you kind of have to ride in the FIS, which is not so cool sometimes, but they don't really like to like put the riders in the first place, or they just want to run the contest through, and well, you know, it's the biggest contest in the world, so, and it's in every 4 years, so I guess it's cool if you go there and do good.
I mean, if you're a pipe rider, there's almost no way around the Olympics. It's like the thing, and this year, more than ever, seems to me. It's like since last year, Sean pushed it really, really big with his own pipe. And then in summertime in Down Under, they were going crazy with new tricks. And now everybody's talking about these double corks. And I think I always try to see the positive side of it. And for the sport, it's a big step again. It's a lot of progression and evolution, and I like to see that.
Yeah, halfpipe snowboarding has been taken to the next level, I guess. I think the double cork will be or was the next step to go, because I don't know, 1260s gets a little too much. So the only thing was to go twice over your head.
The riding level is way more higher now than last year. And I think it's just because of the Olympics, because like everybody wants to win it. And if you win it, it's a really big thing. But it's pretty nice to see some new tricks in pipe, like not always back-to-back tens and stuff like that. It like double corks, it's way more better than spin more like 1260s or 1440s.
For sure, like Olympics and Sean did the double corks, and everybody just wanted to throw it down, which is just totally cool, because then the level has gone more up, and it's sick to see new moves going down in the contests.
When we see something happening, like what happened to Kevin Pearce, we kind of feel that we're going too far, maybe.
Well, it was a sad thing to happen, of course, and it probably like stops you a while to think and stuff, but at the end you start thinking like the snowboarding is all about the progression and stuff. And if you think like the media goes like that snowboarding is too dangerous and you shouldn't do a freaking double corks in the pipe in the Olympics and stuff, that's just, I don't know, that's just weird.
Yeah, I feel really bad for Kevin and what happened to him, but for me it was just an unfortunate accident that could happen to anybody, just riding the slope or trying to go big on a McTwist or like whatever. Especially what's going on right now in the US is pretty ridiculous to me, to limit like sportsmen to, I don't know, to a certain level.
Actually, I just want to go, I think, for my entourage and I don't know, to show that snowboard exists, and I think it's good for French snowboard and also for snowboarding in general. And yeah, I just want to take my chance to go there.
For me personally, it's just I want to be there once and I want to feel how it is. I think I'm good for a season to be in the Swiss Olympic team and do all that stuff.
I think we got the best vibe ever in the within the Swiss team right now, and I really love to hang with these guys, and it's fun to push each other, and I guess it's the last chances for me to really see and push myself and see how much potential I really got in me, and that was like a challenge for myself actually.